Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. I'd like to start this video off by congratulating the good people of Oklahoma. Oklahoma is now a constitutional carry state as of yesterday, November 1st. That means they no longer need the government's permission to carry a gun, whether it be open carry or concealed carry. And I'm told it was passed by bipartisan support. So that is a good thing, as well as encourages the rest of us. Amidst this time when we're watching these people who are trying to become the president talk about banning this and banning that, they're talking about mandatory buybacks, government buybacks, in which the government never owned our guns to begin with. I'm not sure how they could buy them back. You may remember the Hispanic wannabe Beto O'Rourke, or Robert O'Rourke, saying this, and we'll come back and see how well that worked out for him.
Hell yes, we're going to take your AR-15, your AK-47. We're not going to allow it to be used against our fellow Americans anymore.
Just yesterday, Beto ended his bid for president. He could not get out from underneath 1% in the polls. But he was a hero at the Democratic debates when he said, we're going to take your guns, we're going to do this, we're going to do that. Amongst a fishbowl of liberals, he was a hero, but when he got out into the real world, he couldn't answer questions like, how are you going to get the guns from the gangbangers and the criminals and the killers? How exactly are you going to do that? And then how would you leave good, honest, law-abiding Americans defenseless by taking their guns? Which wouldn't happen, but in his perfect world, they would. While the gangbangers and killers still have theirs. And he couldn't answer that, and he just went downhill from there. And that, too, is encouraging to me and many other 2A supporters. But I want to move this video in a little different direction, because you may remember on August 10th or thereabouts, there was a guy after the El Paso and Dayton shootings. His name was Dmitry Andrachenko, who was open carrying in Walmart. And he recorded himself. He wanted to be a social media hero. He wanted to do it under the backing of the Second Amendment, and said, I wanted to see if Walmart would respect my Second Amendment rights. And he eventually was charged with terrorism. And I made that video and I said, this guy's nothing but an attention whore. He's a poser. He's not one of us. I don't buy his shtick one bit. I do agree with open carrying, and everybody has the right to do that. But the way he did this told me immediately, this guy's not one of us. I do not support him. I do not back him. I want nothing to do with this guy. He's a fake. He's a poser. He's trying to become a hero, and he's going about it the wrong way. Now, this is a poser. This is not a Second Amendment supporter who believes in open carrying. Not gain attention, be a poser, and set the Second Amendment cause back further. And walking around trying to scare people is the wrong motive, and so he got charged with terrorism. What are they trying to accomplish? Are they trying to upload a video, put it on the internet, and be heroes amongst the 2A community and say, see, look at me, I'm fighting for our rights? Well, and they're running away because they see this idiot who's recording everything. This guy's nothing more than a tool, an attention whore, who is setting us back, and we should not stand for. And during that video, or during the comments of that video, I had many people call me a shill, told me I should be supporting this guy, told me that, you know, I'm a FUD, that I really am not a Second Amendment supporter because I don't support this guy, Andrachenko. Well, it just came out again just yesterday, very busy day yesterday, November 1st, is that he pled guilty to making a false police report. Now, one of the things that was not reported during that time is that he called the police prior to his stunt saying that there would be a mass shooting at a Walmart, okay, or an active shooter, one of those. There's going to be an active shooter at a Walmart, you got to get there. And then the guy that was open carrying was him, so he did get charged with terrorism. They dropped that charge, but he pled guilty to making a false report to law enforcement. Now, here's the thing that we need to understand. He was a poser. He said this was one big social experiment. So everybody who said that, you know, you're a FUD, you don't support, you should be supporting this guy, you shouldn't be running him down. It turns out that I was right. All right. We have to be very careful who we support and who we don't support. They are putting anti-gun people into positions where they're carrying a gun in a place, and then they are pretending to be one of us. All right, it's fake, it's fiction, and they're doing this to get the people who are on the fence, who don't know which way, you know, kind of see both sides, and to get them on their side. Don't fall for it. Don't say, well, because I support the Second Amendment, I support everything that everybody does under the Second Amendment banner. We need to support people who, by the way, we have enough people to support as it is, who are already getting ripped off on their rights. We don't need to support a guy like this who is nothing more than using us as pawns in a social media experiment, trying to make a lot of money and go viral all under the banner of the Second Amendment. Let's support the people who really need our support. That's my message today. A lot happened on November 1st, and a lot of it was pretty good. If you like videos like this, please subscribe and share. I always appreciate the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and you guys be safe.